Hello, I'm Krishna Raghavendran, and in this tutorial of MIT App Inventor, we are going to see how to create the screenshot app using MIT App Inventor. So for this, we are going to use the screenshot extension in MIT App Inventor. So first, let me show you how this app works. You need to enter the file name for the screenshot, which it needs to be saved. So I'm going to put screenshot 1 as the file name. Next, here you need to enter the delay in seconds. So I'm going to put 5 seconds as the delay. Now you need to click on the Start Screenshot Service button. Now click on Start Now. Now you can see that the app is closed and you'd be able to see this notification at the top which shows screenshot service and it is running. So when you click on the Capture button here in this notification, after 5 seconds it will take whatever is present in the screen. It will take a screenshot. So let me click on Capture button and now I'm going to go to an app like this. Now after it makes a sound, it means that the screenshot is taken. So we can return to the app by clicking on the notification. Now you can see that the screenshot is visible here and it is also visible in the file manager. So let me go to the file manager here and here I'm going to click on the search icon. Here let me search for the name of the screenshot, which is screenshot 1. So I'll put screenshot 1 here and now I'm going to click on the screenshot 1.png. So let me put screenshot 1 and here you can see the screenshot 1.png. I'll use this photos app. Now you can see that the screenshot is visible. As I told you before, first we are going to download the screenshot service extension. So I'm going to give the link in the description for this website where you can scroll down and you can download the AIX file or the extension file which we are going to use. Let me click here and it will be downloaded automatically. After downloading the AIX file, in MIT App Inventor, let's import the extension. So click on import extension and then I'm going to import the extension or the AIX file. Now you can see that the extension is imported, the screenshot service extension. So let me bring it in to the viewer. Next, I'm going to put the title of this app. So let's bring in the label and here let me put the text of this to be screenshot. Now I'm going to make the font to be bold and let me increase the font size of this to be 25 like this. Next, I'm going to put this to be at the center of screen one. So here, let me put the align horizontal to be center like this. And now you can see that this label came to the center of the screen. Next, we are going to bring in a text box where they will type the file name of the screenshot. So let me put the hint of this to be file name or screenshot file name. I'm going to rename this text box from text box 1 to file name text box. So here I'm going to put the name to be file name. Next, I'm going to bring in another text box and this text box is for the delay. So let me put the hint of this to be delay. And again, I'm going to rename this to be delay. Now make sure you check this box which shows numbers only, because in the delay they need to enter the number of seconds and there should be no letters like this. Next, we are going to bring in an image where we can show the screenshot. Also, we will bring in a button so that they can start the screenshot service. So here the text of this button is going to be Start Screenshot Service. I'm going to put the font of this to be bold. And here in this image, this image is where the screenshot is going to be shown. So I'll put the height and width of this image to be fill parent so that it occupies the whole screen like you can see here. Next, here you can see there are some properties in this extension which you can edit. So you can edit the button text, the capture button, and then here you can put the delay. So we are going to put the delay to be whatever they type in the file name in the block section. So let's see what other properties are there. Next, you can put the file name. So now this is the default one, but we are going to change it in the block section by we are going to put the file name which they have entered in this text box. The same way we have the notification text and the notification title and also the shutdown button text. If you want, you can also put an icon for this by uploading, which will be visible in the notification. Now let's go to the block section. So first, when button 1 is clicked, so button 1 is this button, Start Screenshot Service button. So what we are going to do is we will save the file name and the delay, and after it is saved, we will start the screenshot service using this extension. So what I'm going to do is, here you can see we have a block called set-screenshot-service1.filename2. Let me bring in this block and the file name is going to be whatever they type in this text box. So let me bring in, here you can see there's a block called file name dot text. Let me bring in this block. Also, we will use the join block because we need to give the extension for this, the file extension. So let me bring in the text block like this, and here I'm going to put the file extension, which is .png, like this, so that it will be saved as a png file. Next, what we are going to do is we are going to put the delay. We are going to save the delay. So for that, here you can see there's a block called set-screenshot-service1.delay2. Let me bring in this block. And here what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it to be the text which is entered in this delay text box, which is delay.text, like this. Next, after we save both of these, we need to start the screenshot service. So for that, let's go here. And here you can see there's a block called call-screenshot-service1.start-service. So let's bring in this block so that the service will be started. After the screenshot service is started, the user, there'll be a pop-up which will ask the user whether to accept or deny the service. So for that, let's go here, and we are going to bring in this block. When type-screenshot1-service after media projection permission request. Here, this means that after the user selects the permission request, either it can be accept or deny, we need to close this app so that they can take the screenshot of some other app. So let me bring in an if condition, and here I'm going to bring in if get got permission like this, and then here I'm going to put let's go to this screenshot service, and let me bring in this block move task to back. So what this will do is this will close this app so that they can take a screenshot of some other app. After the screenshot is taken and they return back to this app, it needs to show the screenshot in this image one component. So for that, what we are going to do is here, let's go to the type-screenshot-service, and here you'd be able to see, let's go to screen one, and here you would be able to see when screen one dot initialize, which means that the app is starting. So here what we are going to do is we will set the image one dot picture to, let me bring in this block, and I'm going to delete this one. The picture is going to be whatever the screenshot which they had taken. So we are going to put the file name here. So for that, let's go to the text, and here we are going to use the join block because we need to join two items. First, I'll bring in this text block, and here I'm going to put file, and then make sure you put a colon and like this. Next, here we will select the file. So for that, let's go to this extension, and here you can see there is a block called type-screenshot-service1.last-screenshot. So let's bring in this block so that the picture will be visible. Now there is a small change which you need to do to this delay block. So here let's go to the math blocks, and I'm going to bring in the multiplication operation like this. Here I'll put delay.text multiplied by 1000. So let me go to math again, and here I'm going to put an integer like 1000. So I'm going to put 1000 because we need to convert the seconds which they type in this text box to milliseconds. So to convert to milliseconds, we will multiply with 1000, like you can see here. Now let us test the app and let's see if it is working. When you test the app, make sure you don't use the MIT AI to companion to test, because it doesn't work in the MIT AI to companion app. Make sure you build the app into an APK file, like you can see here. Either you can scan the QR code or you can download the .apk file and transfer it to the mobile so that you can install the screenshot app and test it. It doesn't work in the MIT AI to companion. So here you can see the app. First, I'm going to type the file name of this to be sample screenshot. Next, I'm going to put the delay of this to be 5 seconds like I did earlier. And now I'm going to click on start screenshot service to start the service like this. Now click on start now. Now you can see that the app is closed like this, and you would be able to see a notification here at the top which shows screenshot service is running. Now when you click on the capture button after 5 seconds, because I have put the delay as 5 seconds, after 5 seconds it will take whatever is in the screen. So let me click on capture, and now I'm going to open the AI to companion to capture it like this. After you hear the sound, it means that it has been captured. So I can return back to the app by clicking on this notification. Now you can see that you need to click on allow, and now you can see that the screenshot which I captured is visible here. It is also saved in the file manager. So let me go to the file manager. And now I'm going to go to the internal shared storage. Here let me click on search, and I'm going to search for the name, which is sample screenshot. Now you can see that it is visible, sample screenshot.png. Let me click on this, and I'm going to use the photos app to open this like this. Now you can see that it is, the screenshot is visible in the photos app. So you can see that it is visible in the photos app. Next, you need to share the screenshot. So for that, watch this video where I tell you how you can share images using MIT App Inventor, and also watch my full course of MIT App Inventor to create more apps.